Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about multi-row chart visual in the Visuals with Nags series. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So when to use this multi-row chart, it's like where you can combine the multiple measures in a group. You might have aware of a chart visual where you can able to see only a single measure in that chart visual. In the case of multi-row chart visual, you can have more than one measures. That is what you can combine multiple measures in a group. Chart visual with a slice with a dimension, meaning like in a typical single chart visual, you can have only a measure, or you can have some categorical value as first or max or last value. In chart visual, what you can have is like along with the measures, you can also have a dimension. So you can slice your measures with your dimension as well. That is another important feature. It is alternative to a chart visual for fancy look, right? I mean, it contains some good look having a bar, and you can change the colors. So that is the another important factor you can go for it. Let's try to check it out how this visual works in Power BI. Now we are in Power BI, and this is a typical chart visual, and this is not our focus, but to demonstrate a differentiate between the chart and the multi-row chart, I have added this three visuals. You can see the different measures here, item amount. Let me increase the size slightly so that it will be easy for you to view. So this is the item amount, and I will do the format painter. This is fine. Item quantity and cost price. Each measure is viewed separately in a chart visual. This is the visual here. You can see it here. Now coming to our subject, we are focusing on multi-row chart. So what it does? So multi-row chart visual, usually you can able to add multiple measures, the same measures whatever we have seen, item amount, item quantity and cost price. So you can see here these three amounts, you can have it over here, and you can have a more control also. Either you can view it in horizontal or vertical manner. Now it's in vertical and you can have it as horizontal. So based on sometimes like you cannot fit the chart visuals properly, in those cases it can be a perfect alternative for you. Another good feature, as I mentioned, it is having bar control, where I always like this feature. You can see here you can add it, so you can differentiate different bars with some coloring. Like for key measures here, item amount, item quantity, cost price, you can add it as a red, and some other measures you can add it as a blue, some different bars over here, right? So this is what one of the fancy looking visual. Coming to the actual point over here is like you can add a dimension to it. What I'm trying to say, I have a single measure now where I'm going to have the category name, like over here, that is the new dimension. Now as soon as I add it, you can see I will slightly increase the size so that people can view it. I will increase the category name as well. Categorical label, it is not a categorical label, it's a card title actually. So when I increase it, the category title, okay, you can see here for each category I have this item amount splitted, okay, whereas in single card visual you cannot have it. This is what a multi row card visual, either you can have a multiple measures or a single measure with a dimension. So it's not a single measure actually, you can also have another measure. You can see now how it looks like. So it combines these two measures in a single row, okay. It groups, either you can use it as a two or multiple measures over like this, okay. Either here this is one option, or you can use it as a reduce reduct I mean as a vertical or horizontal bars Okay, this is second option. And you can also, what you can do is like you can add another dimension to it with multiple meshes. What will happen here? Now you can expand it. Usually it is good to advisable it based on your business, not more than two meshes. Like you can see properly different category. I mean, in each categorical item, you have item amount and item quantity. So basically used to measure the current year and previous year sales for different categorical values, so that easily compare our variance percentage, right? So those kind of measures can be easily analyzed. So this is perfect measure for your showing your KPIs and with different coloring combinations. I hope you like this video. If you like it, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.